you'll need a flat bench and a pair of dumbbells for this next program.
Working some push-ups for this exercise, and we're getting some assistance from the bench just to create a little bit of elevation, and this will make the push-up fairly easy. Just make sure you're cautious enough not to tip the bench over. Your turn to try this one. Using the tip of the bench for some triceps dips for this exercise. Now you can see I'm doing it with straight legs so that I can't cheat. And you've just got to make sure that your butt stays really close to your hand. We don't want to cause any excess pressure in the rotator cuffs. Your turn to try this one. Elevated hips raise for this exercise. So I'm starting off seated in front of the bench with my arms on the bench in a crucifix position. And then I'm gonna use my arms to assist me, and I'm gonna really squeeze up with my hips until I've created a straight line. I'm gonna drop back down, touch my tailbone to the floor, and go again. This one's a fantastic glutes and back exercise. Let's get you to try this one for yourself. Modified burpee for this one. So you can see I'm using the bench, so it's going to make the push-up a little bit easier. This is a great version of doing burpees for beginners in particular, and it's a great warm-up exercise as well. So getting into that push-up and then jumping back, and you can see I'm not jumping up at the end either, so I'm just trying to keep the joint impact off my knees when I do this exercise. Your turn to try it.
let's grab a pair of dumbbells for this next segment.
Unilateral flat chest press for this one, guys. So you can see I'm holding the left side up and I'm starting my reps with the right side. I'm going to get a bunch in and then I'm going to switch it up and hit the left side as well. And then I'm going to finish off by going bilateral and hitting both sides together. Your turn to try it. Unilateral neutral grip presses for this one. So I'm going to hold one side up and I'm going to do my repetitions on one side only, just making sure that my elbows are tucked in and I'm just drawing some parallel lines at the top of it. Now, when I finish hitting it with my right, I'm going to do a set with my left and then I'm going to finish it up by doing a bilateral set, doing both sides together. Your turn to try this one. for this exercise, we're going to work some shoulder presses, but we're going to do them unilateral. We're going to do them one side at a time. So you can see that I'm pressing with my right arm while the left arm is remaining static. And when we finish the set, we're going to switch it up and work the other side. Now, make sure there's no rotation of the wrists and keep your knees slightly bent in order to protect your back. And let's go from there. Your turn. Working some L-shaped delts raises for this exercise. We're doing them one at a time. So you can see that my left side is holding isometric and it's the right one that's actually doing the exercise. At the end of the set, we're going to switch them up and work the other arm. Your turn to try this one. We'll be right back. working some circular shrugs, starting with one side to begin with. And then what we'll do is we'll switch it up and do the opposite side. And then we're going to finish up by doing both sides. So bilateral movement at the end of it. Your turn to try it. Bent over unilateral rows for this one. So you can see I'm holding one of my arms right up at my ribs in that finishing position of the rows, and then I'm just doing my reps with my other arm. Now we want to make sure that your elbows are relatively well tucked in and it's just a straight up and down motion. Once you finish this set, switch hands and do the other side as well. Your turn to try it. We'll be right back. the neutral spine, we're going to bend forward and we're going to hold up a bent over row isometric pose. So you want to make sure your elbows are tucked in and you want to pull those dumbbells in all the way to your ribs, and we want to hold it there. Now you want to make sure that you don't look down. You want to look in front of you, so you're encouraging your back to remain in the right position and to stay nice and neutral. Your turn. Working some bent over unilateral T rows for this exercise, but you can see that I've kept the isometric side nice and tight by my ribs, so I'm getting that really good lats and biceps contraction and holding it on one side, and then really focusing on pulling my elbows out and hitting the T rows on the other side. We're going to do one side and then switch it up and do the other side as well. Your turn. Let's all run on the spot with high knees for the next 30 seconds. Your turn.
Thank you.
monkey push-up for this exercise. So rather than doing your push-up from your feet, we're just going to do it from our knees. Now, very important with this one, you've got to maintain a straight line from your shoulder to your knee. Where people go wrong with this one is they lift their bum and it takes away the core engagement. So we want to make sure that we're not doing that. Because you're on your knees and it's a fairly easy push-up, let's try and make it nice and deep. Let's go down all the way and come straight back up. Your turn to try this one. Let's hop into some in and out squats for the next 30 seconds. Your turn. Getting into some rotating chops for the next 45 seconds. Your turn to have a go. Front and back hops on the spot for the next 30 seconds. Your turn to try it. Mountain climber from a prone floor position for this one. So you notice that I'm nice and light on my toes. The front foot doesn't touch the floor at all, okay? All your weight is on 3 points, your back foot as well as your two hands. Try and maintain your height as well as you can, and just nice lengthy mountain climbers for this one. Your turn. half burpee for this exercise. Now, this is a nice low impact version of a burpee, and it's much easier. Basically, all we're doing is we're dropping down. There's no push-up component, and there's also no jump at the end of it. So we're taking the joint impact away from this exercise. So just drop down, get into that prone position, and then get straight back up and start from the beginning. Your turn to try this one. Let's all run on the spot with high knees for the next 30 seconds. Your turn. Push-up for this exercise. So rather than doing your push-up from your feet, we're just going to do it from our knees. Now, very important with this one, you've got to maintain a straight line from your shoulder to your knee. Where people go wrong with this one is they lift their bum and it takes away the core engagement. So we want to make sure that we're not doing that. Because you're on your knees and it's a fairly easy push-up, let's try and make it nice and deep. Let's go down all the way and come straight back up. Your turn to try this one. Let's hop into some in and out squats for the next 30 seconds. Your turn. Getting into some rotating chops for the next 45 seconds. Your turn to have a go.
front and back hops on the spot for the next 30 seconds. Your turn to try it.
Mountain climber from a prone floor position for this one. So you notice that I'm nice and light on my toes. The front foot doesn't touch the floor at all, okay? All your weight is on 3 points, your back foot as well as your two hands. Try and maintain your height as well as you can, and just nice lengthy mountain climbers for this one. Your turn.
Working some mini sprint steps using your favorite leg for the next 30 seconds. Your turn. Well done for finishing your workout, guys. Please take a few minutes to stretch and cool your body down now.
If you enjoyed this workout segment, please assist us by liking and sharing. Remember to subscribe for your daily workout fix.